Hello students, hope you are doing good. So in this lecture we'll be just covering the concepts of inner classes in Java. So as its name suggests, a class that is defined inside another class is known as an inner class. So for example, if there is a class A and you have declared or defined another class B inside this class A, such that the class A has wrapped this class B, then the class B is known as the inner class of class A. So based on the implementation, Java provides three types of inner classes. So you can create three types of inner classes in Java. So the first is the non-static inner class, or it is also known as the member class. So like other member functions or the another variables of a class, okay, so that are non-static in nature. So in the same way, this class is like a member of a class that uses it, that implements it, that wraps it. So it can be a non-static class, it can be a static inner class, and the third, that is very important, that is an anonymous inner class. So anonymous means without any name. So the class that is not having any name is known as an anonymous inner class. So this anonymous inner class is widely used in event handling kind of things in Java. So we will see an example of how we just create an anonymous class in spite of creating our own class. Okay, as we have seen in the earlier lecture, that we are just registering the object of our current object of our class in the components. So in the same way, in spite of registering the particular component, okay, the instance of our class, we just create the anonymous class object. We will see it in the subsequent lectures how it can be done. So our main focus is how to create a non-static inner class and how to access the members of the non-static inner class and how to access and how to create a static inner class. So first is the non-static inner class. So it has a syntax like this: class outer class. Okay, so class outer test is the outer class. It can have certain members, and inside this we have created a class that is inner test, and it can also have certain members. And this is the complete definition of this class. So this is a general syntax, how we declare a class. So how to, the main question is that how to access the members of a non-static inner class. So now this, the topic is that we have just created another class inside the class. So how to access the members that are declared in this inner class? It cannot be accessed directly, as we are accessing the members of our classes just by creating the objects of our class. So there's, in this type of scenario, there must be some important points that we have to remember, that how to access the members. So I have taken an example for understanding. I have created a class outer test in which I have just declared a variable and initialized it with some value. So int x is equal to 10. X is a variable of type integer and it contains a value 10. I have created a class inner test and it contains an integer type variable y that contains the value 20. So now how will we access this y that is of prime importance? Okay, so how will this access the value of y? How will we just invoke this y? That is very important. So we can't create the object of inner class directly in order to access y. So it's not like we just create the object of outer class, outer test, and with the help of this outer test we are just accessing the y. It is not possible in this case. Here we can only access the variable x with the help of the object that is created of class, that is of class outer test. If we create an object of class outer test, then it is possible to access the value of x only, that is the member of outer test, but we cannot access the value of y. We cannot access the data member y with the object of the outer class. So there are certain rules that how we can access. So first, if the condition is that the class is non-static, if the class inner class is non-static, then we have to create the object of the outer class. That is mandatory. Okay, it is mandatory to create the object of the outer class. Okay, so the object of the outer class must be created. Next is, with the help of the object of outer class, so when we have created this outer test out, is equal to new outer test. So an object of outer class is now been created. Now with the help of this out, we should create the object for the inner class in order to access the variable y. So how we will create? We will create it with the help of outer test dot inner test. It means that this inner test belongs to outer test, because outer class has wrapped this inner class in itself. So this inner class is now a part of outer test. It belongs to outer test. So compiler should correlate this thing with the help of this dot operator, that this inner test is a part of outer test. So we will just create outer test dot inner test, and here I have just forgotten to write a variable. So we'll just create a reference variable of type outer test or inner test. You can create any reference variable, ir, ix, anything. So I have just missed it, so you just correct it. We will just correct it when we'll just implement it with the help of a program. So here there must be certain reference variable of type outer test dot inner test is equal to out. So this is the object of the outer class. So with the help of the object of the outer class, we are just invoking this inner test. So as you have seen that when we want to access the methods, so how we access the methods? With the help of object dot. So here also we will just write object of the outer class dot, and we just create the object of the inner class with the help of this new operator. So this is the method to access, to create the object of the inner class when the inner class is non-static in nature. So two things you should just keep in your mind, that outer class object must be created if the inner class is non-static. It is mandatory. And with the help of the object of the outer class, you will create the object of the inner class. That is very important. So now the next topic is, we just see what is the static inner class. So the static inner class doesn't require any outer class object. So here you doesn't require to create any outer class object. It is independent of outer class object. As we know that when we create any variable or any method of type static, then it is independent of the object of the class to which it belongs. So in the same way, we are not going to create the object of the outer class here. So if the same example we are taking, that we have to access now the value of y, and the class inner test is now static in nature. So this is now static in nature. So this is static. So in the previous example, this keyword was absent because this is non-static in nature. Now we should access, we must create something in order to access this y, because this y cannot be accessed by this object of outer test, because this is static in nature. So there is no requirement of creating the object of this outer class. So how we can access it? You have to remember certain points, that no outer class object is required because the inner class is static in nature, like any other member function or like any other member variable that are declared as static. That doesn't require any object of the class to which it is declared as static member. Second, to invoke the inner class, we require the object of inner class. Now we have to create the object of inner class if the inner class is static in nature. And it is created like this. This is the syntax, outer dot inner. It means this inner class is dependent on outer class because it is declared inside this outer class. So this outer class is wrapping this inner class. So this dot, it means that it belongs to outer class, and this is the reference variable that we have created of type outer dot inner is equal to new outer dot inner. So in this way, in this way, an object of the inner class is created. So in order to create the object of inner class, we don't have to use the object of outer class. It is independent of outer class. Outer class object is required only when we have to use non-static inner classes, then it is mandatory. But when static classes are there, then there is no requirement of outer class object. So we'll just implement these examples in the subsequent lectures, and then you'll be just able to get how this concept is working. So till then, stay happy, and just try to practice some more questions, or just try to learn these concepts, and just we'll implement it in the subsequent lectures. Thanks.